The Dish TV Videocon D2H merger is finally complete, creating a direct-to-home company which has a healthy mix of rural and urban presence. The average revenue per user, or ARPUs, may have disappointed a tad bit in the last quarter, but the management commentary suggests that it is only going to get better from here on. Is that so? We talk about that and more with the man in charge of Dish TV, the managing director, Jawaharlal Goel. He joins us right now on the show. Mr. Goel, good having you. Thanks so much for joining in. You know, I'll take a cue from a report, Mr. Goel, which speaks about Dish TV's recent performance and says that underlying trends are a tad weaker. It is the merger synergies which will drive the stock performance. Would you agree with this?
Well, we had seen, as we spoke on the our investor community, the synergy level is on the track, which is around 570 crore for this financial year and about 750 crore next financial year, which we are envisaging. The ARPU thing has been misnomer for our company because we have been counting the subscriber number on 120 days due basis. Now we had come down to 60 days due basis, and the total size of my subscriber base is 24 million subscriber. As far as the revenue is concerned, there was a growth, but not that much, but we had the expense of the merger expenses and some few more one-off item. So this was the last year's financial and the quarter, last quarter's financials. When we come to the new trend, the coming quarters, we had a healthy the cricket season in this, but at the parallelly we had a Ramzan period. So these are the subscriber numbers and the revenues that is always based on some events which I always have. You know that we have a churn percentage of about 0.8 or 9%, which in our immediate competition like cable, they are not yet factoring those churns. So this is one of the criteria which there is a disparity in the industry.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so based on the answer that you've given me, Mr. Goel, would Q1 also be a bit difficult to predict because of the events that have happened? And part two of my question would be, how does FY19 look on the revenue front? The brokerage notes seem to suggest that most of the revenue growth will be driven by ARPU improvement, which is probably around 9 or 10% for FY19, the revenue growth that people are factoring in. Are these numbers reasonably believable?
Yeah, this is what we are envisaging, about 9-10% revenue growth in this whole year.
Okay, and Q1 will be a bit mixed because of the two events that you spoke about and therefore difficult to predict?
Well, actually we don't give it such advisory on the media side, because we have a healthy relationship with our shareholders. We do a quarterly and conference call, and one-to-one we meet them. So the as a management, we don't do any guidance on the quarterly, the coming quarter.
Okay.
But I think it should be better, yeah.
Okay, fine. Then I won't press you for that. Let me try and get your thoughts on two or three concerns that people might have. You mentioned the 9 to 10% revenue growth, largely led by ARPU growth. Now, how would you believe these three factors would play out? One, the increase in rural demand, which everybody's been waiting for, but hasn't quite come about with full gusto. Will that happen? And the competitive intensity, one from your natural competitors, from DD Free Dish as well, will all of that be a risk that you will easily absorb and face?
Well, we in our operator business, we always have a overhang of some event or the other. The free DC is one of them. They have not been able to take a decision on what to do. But as we have to live within the constraint of the industry or external factor and do our business. So we had devised something to tackle that issue as well. There was also OTT or geo impact, which the people have been talking. But we understand that they will be doing on fiber to home kind of a scenario with triple play, which is best suited for high-rise building. But on the row houses and the low-density area or B or C-class cities, it is a slightly high capex issue. So we have to see and watch how they pan out in Bombay or Pune or city like Gurgaon. Definitely they will take market share. That is the best, that is a good technology, wide technology. But at the same time, when we talk to the content provider, they don't have agreement for providing to the content to the big screen like TV. So small screen contract has been there. But we'll see how this is just a beginning and how the industry pan out. We will accordingly reset our strategy.
Interesting. Mr. Goyal, when I speak to the cable companies, all of them are hopeful. I mean, they of course have this broadband revenue base, which is separate, but purely on the connections for televisions, they are very hopeful of their ARPUs increasing by a large proportion of their existing customers converging or converting to HD. You, I'm sure, have that process ongoing now for a number of years. How do the next 2 or 3 years look like in terms of conversions from SD to HD and thereby the growth in ARPU that you envisage from your customer base?
Well, in India, we have a big, very huge range of the subscriber. There is a subscriber who do the family viewing, the subscriber who still have a CRT TV, you know, the picture tube TV. And for your viewer, I would like to, I am told that in the country, we still have 55% CRT TV population. So out of 150 million TV household, if 75-80 million is still the CRT TV, then question is that high def is how much premium the customer is willing to pay, and those television are not equipped to receive high definition content. So the country is evolving, and it is not overnight. It will be the change from flat TV and CRT TV. We still have market for black and white CRT TV. Yeah.
No, so sir, so I appreciate that. So therefore, my question then would be that keeping all of these in mind, and you would know the pulse of the customer over years of managing Dish TV the way you have, what's the kind of growth in ARPU do you envisage as a result of this pure function of a movement from SD to HD? Will that be meaningful?
Well, that's why we had given a guidance of 8 to 9%,
which is for FY19
revenue increase.
Yeah,
that is a mix of everything.
Okay.
Yeah.
No, but what about
that is
the next,
a mix of everything that will come from high definition.
Years?
Yeah. I think it is a welcome step that the cable industry is now are geared up to for high definition content and also for data service. I think, and also they will start counting the churn, they will have their last mile operator registered with GST. So all these things will definitely increase the ARPU.
Okay. My final question, Mr. Goel, and that is on what happens on the operational front and thereby on the bottom line front. You've guided to about 7, 8, 9% growth on revenue for FY19, which is fine. If I'm not wrong, the guidance on EBITDA is about 34 or 35% versus 31% in FY18. What leads you to this confidence in growth in EBITDA? And therefore, what's the kind of subsequent growth in bottom line do you envisage?
See, 34-35% guidance which we had given to our investor community is based out of two, three things. One is the synergy on the merger, and number two is the revenue ARPU increase. Maybe we will start working on the PAT kind of environment from next year, so that we really have a different yardstick to measure our company. So far we have been on a beta base. From next year we will go on the bottom line total profitability base. This is what I hope and I discuss with my management team. So these are the good years are coming ahead. On data side, I think OTT and all these things, the prices of per GB data has come down as low as 17 rupees per gigabyte, which may not stay there, but even nevertheless, as this TV or DTH companies, especially this TV, my content cost is 10 rupees per month to deliver to the homes about 500-600 channels. So this is one area of method of delivery, which is a different technology, which on IP base it is going to be expensive for consumer to consume the content.
Okay, Mr. Goel, we'll leave it at that. Many thanks for joining in today and giving us that perspective, and all the best for FY19.
Thank you very much. Thank you. All the best.